We are here at the Higher Education Technology Conference and we have with us EdTechReview CEO, Mr. Utkarsh Lokesh. Sir, first of all, I want to ask you about the EdTechReview, this conference, what platform it gives to the...
Sure. So we, our aim through this conference was to bring together everyone involved in higher education, whether it's a service provider, whether it's institution, solo institute or a university, and talk about the upcoming trends in higher education. So in terms of technology implementations across the higher education domain. So whether it's for the key elements of curriculum, instruction, assessment, examination or admission. So we tried to cover majority of the topics around how institutions currently are practicing and also at the same time how industry is supporting the same.
So in the conference it was discussed the gap between the academics and the industry.
Yeah.
So according to you, what can be done to overcome the gap, to fill the gap?
Sure. So a lot which was shared by the panelists as well is more around giving them the exposure to the industry. What does industry experience mean for a student? You cannot imagine the importance of the same, right? So unless they have that experience and exposure to what industry looks like and what industry needs, those skills, if they are talked about by the faculty and if the faculty themselves have the exposure, then it can actually help them bridge the gap in a dynamic or I would say a changing economy, because that's what people need. Like everything is changing so rapidly. If they are exposed to those kind of changes through the industry experts, that will help bridge the gap in form of whether internships or whether, let's say, even part-time certifications and those kind of things.
How can you think the government can help in transforming education to build the gap, to fill the gap?
I think one of this was discussed today by a lot of people from the academia. It was around if they allow the industry's participation in classroom more openly. Like, it's not necessary that you need a PhD to kind of have an expertise on something, right? So if they are not just degree based, certification based kind of entry to a faculty member, if they are real practitioners understanding the use case in the industry, if they talk about its implementation in the classroom, that makes more sense. So I think if the government can be a little flexible around that, that will be a huge boon.
Do you think that transformation of course, the course the students study in colleges or in higher education, do you think transformation in these is needed?
Yeah, absolutely. So I think from what I get from your question is like around the curriculum, right? So I think it's always needed to be dynamically kind of updated, because things, as I said, like things are changing so rapidly that people need to stay abreast around what is current. So even if a course on engineering which was like applicable 10 years back, it's not same today. So how you upgrade that curriculum, how you bring the technology element to it, not just for the sake of it, but to actually improve the whole experience of engagement, curriculum, instruction, pedagogy, and then assessment at the end of it, so that the learning outcomes are obtained what you wanted to be.
Thank you so